As a data analyst working in Google Sheets, one of the first things I need to do before I can even start working on any of the data is collecting that data to make sure it's all in one place, easy to use, easy to find. Now, I've already made a video right here that you can check out that describes how to combine multiple worksheets into one file. But one thing that I completely glossed over is this question. Is there an easier way to copy the links of the worksheets? I have more than 500 sheets and copying their links one by one is going to take me ages. Please help. Now, of course we can do that. Let's check it out. I have this Google Drive folder that I keep a whole bunch of spreadsheets in. There's 584 spreadsheets in here, just in these bits, and then others that I've got in these folders. So when you're in this folder, let's click on New Google Sheets. That's going to make sure that this Google Sheet is saved within this folder. From here, we'll go up to Extensions, App Scripts. Now we're going to create our function in two parts. The first part is going to be reading all of the spreadsheet IDs from each of the files within the folder. The second part is just going to be writing the spreadsheet IDs into the spreadsheet that we just created. First, you'll see this function, my function. Let's just select all of that and delete it. Get spreadsheet IDs. Open a double bracket and then a curly bracket. We'll press enter a few times. Now, SSIDs is already a thing, but we'll just go with it anyway, remembering that SS stands for spreadsheets. First, let's set our variables. So we use constant folder ID equals, and then we're going to go back to our drive folder and then select the ID. Now, if this is the whole URL, the ID is this part on the end. So we can just double click that part and it'll select all of it. And then back in our script editor, we'll paste that in between those single quotation marks. Let's finish with a semicolon and then move to the next variable. This is going to be const folder. We'll use driveApp.getFolderById. That's this first one. Open a bracket and we'll put in there folder ID, which is going to be reading this folder ID because that's what we named it before. Next up, we're going to use const files equals folder.getFilesByType. That's the third one in the list down here. And we're only going to be getting Google Sheets. And then our last variable, we'll use spreadsheet IDs. And that's just square brackets with nothing inside them. We're going to later put all of the spreadsheet IDs into these square brackets and turn it into an array. We'll use a while, which is a type of loop, files.hasNext. So that's just saying, is there a next file? If there is, then we'll say let file equals files.next, spreadsheet IDs, dot push file dot get ID. So all this is saying is if there is another file, then we're going to be getting that next file. This part here is saying let's get the ID, and then push means we're going to put this into this array. So if there's one spreadsheet ID, we'll put it into the array. If there's another one, we'll put that into the array, and we'll keep going until we've gone through all of the full list. We can finish off with a return spreadsheet IDs, because in the next part, we're going to be writing a function that puts all of the spreadsheet IDs into our new spreadsheet. But before we get onto that, if this has been helpful, make sure you let me know down in the comments by leaving a like and a comment. Let's continue. Our next function is just going to be called write spreadsheet IDs. Let spreadsheet IDs equals the function that we just created before, get spreadsheet IDs. We'll start off with let sheet. So we're going to be naming our sheet. It's going to be spreadsheet app dot get active spreadsheet dot get active sheet. Let's clear the sheet so it's nice and clean for our list of spreadsheets. And now we're going to write all of the spreadsheets in a column. For let I equals zero, I is less than spreadsheet IDs dot length, I plus plus. So all this part is saying is let's go through that array of spreadsheet IDs until we're at the full length. This I plus plus is how we're incrementing each one. So we're going to go from the first one to the next one to the next one and so on down the list. Inside our function, we'll just put sheet.getRange I plus one comma one. So that's just saying our range that we want is our first row, then our second row, third row, and then this part here is just saying the first column. That's column A. If you want your list in column B, then just change this to 2. Let's set the value to each of the spreadsheet IDs. And we're done. We have a closed bracket there. We have a closed bracket there. So we'll click on save. We'll click on run. Actually, I want this one to run, write SSIDs. So I'll change this get SSIDs to write SSIDs and then click run. We have to run through all of the permissions, so we click Review Permissions, click on the account that you want to use, click Advanced, and then go to Untitled Project, Unsafe. Now, the only reason that it says unsafe is because Google hasn't verified this app, so let's click on that anyway. And lastly, let's click Allow. You'll see at the bottom that it's running, and you can see that I made a mistake. This shouldn't be Get ID, this should be Get ID with a lowercase d there. Let's save that and run it again. Execution started. Execution completed. And if we look over here, you can see our full list of spreadsheet IDs. There should be 584 of them. 583 instead of 584, because I counted the spreadsheet we're currently in, making it 584. And now you can take this list of spreadsheet IDs, put them into this video here, and get all of your information together in one place. Thanks.